texture packs. They've been around almost as long as Minecraft has itself, and they can bring new life back to an old world or build. They're also extremely easy to install and set up. Couple that with the fact that there are so many great ones available that range from insane photorealism ones to cool simplistic ones, and it's no wonder why so many people use them. But one thing that people often don't think about when they're using texture packs is how they affect performance. And really, do they at all? Well, since you asked, let's find out, shall we? I guess I'll start out by explaining why different texture packs could potentially perform different from one another. And it all comes down to one thing. And no, it's not how realistic a texture pack looks, it's all about resolution. And not the resolution on your display. Using a higher resolution texture pack does not turn your CRT from the 90s into a bona fide ultra-wide Predator X34. The resolution I'm talking about refers to the amount of pixels on a given face of a texture. Let me explain. If you've downloaded pretty much a texture pack ever before, then you've probably noticed the resolution that some websites will even let you sort by in a drop-down menu. It will often say something like 16x16 or 32x32. What this means is that for a 16x16 texture pack, the texture of a normal block, say a stone block, is 16 pixels by 16 pixels. And in a 64x64 texture pack, the texture of a normal block would be 64 pixels by 64 pixels. This is why a higher resolution texture pack will often have more detail in each of the blocks compared to a lower resolution one. I mean, think of the detail that can be portrayed in pixel art that is 1024 by 1024 versus pixel art that is only 8x8. Big difference. Alright, so with that quick explanation out of the way, let's go back and ask the original question of does a higher resolution texture pack have any noticeable negative performance impacts? I mean, Minecraft is such an easy game to run, surely adding some more textures won't tank performance, right? Well, to find out, I downloaded 5 of the most popular texture packs in various resolutions, including Rodrigo's pack at 8x8, which gives the game an overly basic look in my opinion. Oh great, it's raining. Well anyway, the plastic texture pack, which says on its website that it's a 1.8.9 only pack, so you may have to upgrade or downgrade your Minecraft accordingly. Anyway, the plastic texture pack was a wildly successful pack on the console that was then ported to PC at 16x16. For the next one, I used the ever so popular Faithful pack at 32x32. The Realistic Adventure pack at 64x64 is one that I have used in the past before. And finally, the modding community's favorite, Pure BD Craft at 128x128. Downloads to all of these will be in the link in the video description. So finally, to the test. And some things to be noted are that I threw in the default texture pack, which runs at 16x16 just for reference. Also, it should be noted that all tests were run on Minecraft 1.12 with Optifine on, which I would never consider running Minecraft without. If you want to know more about why, you can check that out up there. I run each test 3 times, recording the average, 1% lows, and 0.1% lows. I then took the average across each test run to get the numbers you are about to see. For benchmarking, I use my standard Minecraft benchmark, which you can learn more about up to there. Finally, if you want to know about my test system hardware specs, those will be in the video description for you to check out. Benchmarking this was interesting, to say the least, because I went from the lowest resolution texture pack to the highest. And starting out with Rodrigo's pack, as you can see, I got a very solid 53 FPS with good percentile figures that never dropped below 30. However, then I moved on to the plastic texture pack, and found that I got roughly the same result, with an average of 51 and around the same percentile figures as well. Okay, moving on to the Faithful pack, and again, an average of 51 and roughly the same percentile figures that almost stay above 30 FPS. Strange, right? And after I got the same results again in the Realistic Adventure pack, I did a quick test using the default texture pack and the same exact results! This video idea was starting to look like a complete waste of time, as everything I had tested was performing identically. So then, in a last attempt, I ran the test with Pure BD Craft, and whoa! Look at that average! Yes, while using Pure BD Craft running at a massive resolution of 128x128, I got an average of 38 FPS and percentile figures that dipped well into the 20s. That's a drop in performance of over 27%. And I did validate these test results and found them to be repeatable using a second PC, which I should have a video showcasing coming up soon in the next month or so. Anyway, back to the task at hand, and these results did surprise me. I figured that eventually if I went high enough in resolution that there would be some kind of a difference in performance, but I thought it would happen much sooner than 128x128. So in conclusion, does having a higher resolution texture pack affect performance? Well, the answer is, as it always seems to be, it depends. And I will admit that I only really tested one hardware configuration, not to mention that I only tested texture resolutions up to 128x128. They go much farther than that. So for you, depending on the type of hardware you're using and depending on the resolution of your specific texture pack, while yes, higher resolution texture packs will affect performance eventually, results may vary. And if you're just wondering whether texture pack A or texture pack B will negatively affect performance, check the resolution. And if it's around 16x16 or 32x32, then you're probably good. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Yeah, this video took way too long to make. Yeah, it was an idea I had quite a long time ago, but I really did want to know, and I wanted to share the results with you. So yeah, hopefully you found this interesting. If you enjoyed this, tell me in the comments below if you want to. If you want to see other things, you can definitely suggest them in the comments. I will probably read all of them, as there will not be many, probably one. But anyway, I want to thank you all very much for watching, and I hope to see you guys next year in the next one. Goodbye!